The Philippine Senate begins its hearings into the massive power outage that hit Panay Island last week. Senate Energy Committee Chairman Rafi Tulfo said the probe seeks to determine the cause of the outage and hold those accountable. Senator Risa Ontiveros, who filed a resolution calling for the investigation, said it may be time to review the legislative franchise of the National Grid Corporation.
In our previous hearings, Mr. Chair, I also have called out NGCP for its repeated failure to fulfill its obligations to the country, even as it rakes in billions in profits for its shareholders. Hindi pa rin natutugunan ang issue ng national security dahil sa 40% ownership ng China sa NGCP.
Mahiya na lang tayo sa mga tao na naghirap at sa mga tao bayad ng napakamahal na kuryente. They really deserve better. Hindi pwedeng sorry na lang parati. Damage has been done and reparations need to be made.
Local leaders of Panay Island were present at the hearing. Iloilo City Mayor Jerry Treñas did not mince words to air his constituents' dismay over the widespread blackouts. Mayor Treñas said the local economy suffered a 2 billion peso loss in the four-day outage.
We are looking for accountabilities. We are not going to sit down this time and just listen to all these inquiries. The last time this happened in April of 2023, nothing happened. No one was held accountable. Unfortunately, some of our friends in the legislature were trying to help defend those who are guilty. This time, we will not allow those people who are responsible to get away with this. How can this four-day blackout, brownout happen in a country that is supposed to be one of the most developing countries in the ASEAN?
Social media giant Meta will hide more content from teens on Instagram and Facebook. This as it faces intense regulatory pressure from around the world to protect children from harmful content. Meta said all teens will now be placed into the most restrictive content control settings on the apps. Additional search terms will also be limited on Instagram. These moves will make it more difficult for teens to come across sensitive content such as suicide, self-harm, and eating disorders. Meta is under pressure both in the U.S. and Europe over allegations its apps are addictive and fuel a youth mental health crisis. A single tweet briefly sends Bitcoin prices soaring. Turns out that message, posted on the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission's official X account, suggesting it had approved the long-awaited launch of a new type of investment product known as an ETF, was unauthorized. Bitcoin prices jumped to almost $48,000, its highest level in more than 22 months. But those prices fell again a few minutes later after SEC clarified market regulators' account had been compromised. Now, the market has been speculating for weeks that the SEC would grant approval for ETF. It offers investors an index fund that replicates the performance of Bitcoin without having to hold the cryptocurrency directly. The World Bank sees global growth slowing down for a third consecutive year. It forecasts global GDP at 2.4% this year, compared to 2.6% last year and 3% the year before. The World Bank says the COVID-19 pandemic, the war in Ukraine, and ensuing spikes in inflation and interest rates have made the first half of the 2020s as likely the worst half-decade performance in 30 years. Now, the World Bank said one way to boost growth, particularly in emerging markets and developing countries, is to accelerate the $2.4 trillion in annual investments needed to transition to clean energy and adapt to climate change. Asian markets are on a downward trend as investors anticipate the release of U.S. inflation data, which could provide clues on when the Fed will begin cutting interest rates. Taking a look now at the board, it's a sea of red for Asian equities, Only Japan's Nikkei 225 is on the rise, continuing its impressive run this week after hitting 33-year highs in the previous session. It breached the 34,000 mark for the first time in over three decades. We're also seeing the ASX 200 in the red after inflation in the country slumped to a near two-year low. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a mixed open just after a brief rally on Tuesday. Stateside Wall Street futures are set to open trading in the red ahead of the release of key economic data, including U.S. inflation data and the U.S. producer price index.
The National Bureau of Investigation and GCash team up to launch a probe on scams involving the e-wallet platform. For more on this story, let's bring in our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Jackie?
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. The National Bureau of Investigation has formally sealed a partnership with e-wallet firm GCash to work together in the investigation of various online scams. A memorandum of agreement signing event was held in Taguig early today. NBI Director Medardo de Lemos said criminal behaviors have changed and crimes are now online. He added that partnerships with fintech companies are crucial to investigate crimes, many of which affect e-wallet accounts. Renren Reyes, President and CEO of GXchange Inc., or that's GCash, said that the partnership would help speed up investigations as the NBI can seek help from GCash if GCash accounts are involved in a crime, and GCash too may seek assistance of the NBI. Aside from helping in the investigation, both parties will also share information or data on the latest trends in cybercrime to help prevent the spread of such incidents or cases. Both the NBI and GCash urge the public to file a formal complaint or police report before they can act on the cases. The NBI admits, though, they need to hire more cyber investigators with the expected increase in the number of complaints. The NBI director asserted that the face of criminal behavior has changed, and now they will need to train more personnel and purchase equipment to intensify the investigation into cyber crimes. And that's the latest. Denise, back to you.
Jackie Pascual with that story. Thanks, Jackie.